Hi, I'm Ed Antonio, the Chief Executive Officer of Account Ventures Inc., the owner and operator of Bok Korean Fried Chicken. So today we're here in our commissary and we will take you on a tour to see how our sauces are made, how we produce them in batch. We'll take you in our R&D process, how we ideate, and as well as your other favorite Bok products such as the corn dog and spaghetti. We're here today in Macro Asia SATS Food Industry. This is Bok's commissary. And here today we have Chef Ems, who will show to us the procedures on how Bok products are made before they are sent to the branches for use. Okay? So, let's go inside.
All right.
Safety first.
Today, we're gonna show you how to cook the yangyum sauce. So first, ilalagay yung oil. Okay, so prior to this, sinimeasure na namin siya one by one, no, para makuha namin yung exact quantity dun sa recipe. We will add the garlic. And then we have to stir it, no? So, halo-halo lang yung gamagin conclusion ko.
So, Bok Chicken started August 2020 in a small cloud kitchen located in Alabang Zapote, Las Piñas City. The idea started around end of May to June, and we started doing our R&D June and July. So we started during the pandemic. This was, I think, during the MECQ period. Although there were not much limitations as to starting a business, we found good opportunity in the delivery segment. So because we were particularly a cloud kitchen only, we took advantage that everybody was staying at home ordering food from delivery platforms such as GrabFood and Foodpanda. So our idea for boneless chicken, of course, came up with that it's a very popular and trendy item today. And naturally, Filipinos love fried chicken, right? Why boneless? Well, we like chicken thigh fillet, okay? Chicken thigh fillet is the juiciest part of the chicken. So that's why we decided to use chicken thigh fillet for our stores. We're 5 partners in total. One of them is my best friend, thesis mate, course mate in De La Salle University. One of them is my neighbor. One of them is my old football teammate. And one of them is my good friends from college also. So all of us were already friends during college and some even high school pa in childhood.
So now we will add the mirin.
So mirin is similar to like white vinegar.
Yes.
Rice vinegar ba to?
Yes.
Okay. So it's an Asian ingredient used in making the sauce. So itong mirin, I think this is what gives it its tangy taste.
Yes. Flavor, yeah. Okay, so we add now the samjang. Kasi lang yung spatula.
So this is one of the most common ingredients used for yangnyum. Yeah. So the samjang. This adds the spice and the bean-like taste of yangnyum sauce.
This is more Korean talaga.
Yes.
For one day, like 500 kilos of this one.
For flavor?
Yes.
Oh.
Our production starts at 7 o'clock. Yeah. ends 4 o'clock. Okay.
So the next sauce is gochujang.
So another Korean ingredients, no, na kailangan ilagay sa ano sa yangyun. Talagang very vital siya gamitin, no.
So we make sure na ano, walang nasasayang.
Yeah.
Because this is already measured. Bok was named something else initially. We planned on naming it first Chicken Plus. But after some research, we found out that Chicken Plus was already an existing business, I think, in Singapore or Malaysia. And based on their website, they said that they were going to be expanding to the Philippines. Yes, so originally, we weren't supposed to be a Korean fried chicken-based company. We were supposed to be just boneless fried chicken. Okay. We came up with Bok because it was the sound of the chicken. It sounds Korean. Okay. And it has an instant brand recognition. So that's how we came up with the name Bok. Then so, we just worked around it.
Now we add the corn syrup. Now we will add sriracha. We add now the ketchup.
We're just trying to adapt from those flavors that already existed. Then, because we found opportunity in the boneless Korean fried chicken market, right? We formulated our own recipes for these sauces that you see that we're producing today.
And we add the cayenne.
Yes, so our original business was actually steak and chicken and more. We serve chicken leg, we serve ribeye steak, Hungarian sausages, right? So, of course, I just went back to chicken because it's one of the most familiar things for Pinoys. It's the easiest to market. And take note, this time, I still had a full-time job. I was working as a senior associate in SGV. So, interestingly, my partners and I were all actually from a financial background. None of us have any background or culinary background during college. So, particularly, my partner and I were both CPAs. Mai and Deo, they both work in different banks. Okay? So, during this time, we had to juggle, of course, our full-time jobs and starting a small business. Right? But, with that, I had to think of an easy business to start that could be that could scale up quickly. So of course, we were thinking of different products. Chicken is the most familiar for Pinoys, right? It's the most familiar. There's a million recipes you can find online, okay? And I was just thinking of a business where one product could succeed, and that's where we found chicken.
We believe 45 minutes boiling. Then we add the islari and the sesame oil. Then it's done. So lastly, we're adding the islari.
Bango! So ito yung nagpapa lapot.
That gives you nice consistency. You know? You smell it?
Yep. Sarap. That's yangnyum. Sesame oil for the smell.
And we're done.
So today, we're gonna make a sauce that maybe you can try at home. Yeah. This is a sauce that we really like and it's called the kimchi, creamy kimchi sauce. Okay, so Chef Ems, can you explain to us how we come up with sauces and how we and how the viewers at home can make this also.
Kasi, okay, si kimchi, di ba, parang you can prepare it also at home, di ba? Parang ang dali niya lang gawin, no? So, syempre, pag sinabing kimchi, di ba, Korean talaga ang kimchi. So, yon. So, naisipin namin na gumawa ng creamy kimchi sauce na very ideal sa business ni Bok, which is yung fried chicken.
Okay, so we have the ingredients over here. So, let's start cooking the sauce.
First, we have to add the 22 grams of butter. We have to add 2 grams of garlic, chopped garlic.
Dito sa Bok, gusto namin ng garlic lagi eh.
Yeah, mag-garlic si Bok eh, no?
Okay, then...
So, then we have to add 3 grams of chopped onion.
Mahal pa ba yan?
Mahal ang onion, di ba ginto nga si onion. So, here you can, whatever onion you want to use, either white or red, pwede siya. But in this recipe, we use the red. No?
Okay, so before we started in an industrial kitchen like this, an industrial commissary, of course, we had our humble beginnings just making sauces in our friend's grandma's backyard. As in, dun talaga kami nag-start. We were experimenting with different sauces. We were throwing in different recipes, ingredients. Okay?
Yeah. Yeah. So, pag na-add na natin yung garlic and then the onion, nag-translucent na siya, we have to add the flour. So, just mixed with the butter, no? The flour.
Nung nag-experiment kami ng mga different sauces, kung ano-ano linalagay namin. Parang we're trying to kasi make the chicken crunchy. Naglalagay kami ng beer, naglalagay kami ng Sprite. Mm. So, ano talaga?
Diba sa paggawa lang kasi ng recipe, you have to be creative eh, diba? So, hindi naman aangal yan eh. Basta anything na ilagay mo, basta masarap, okay
tayo. So yung R&D talaga namin, it's really experimental. You really have to trial and error to see what works.
Correct.
Otherwise, wala. But that's the cost of doing business eh.
Then we have to add 155 grams of fresh milk.
So ito, just like this, of course, don't be afraid to be creative.
Yeah.
So right. We have to test different recipes, different ingredients, of course. Ito, hindi lang naman to one time ginawa, no?
Actually, nagtatrial error kami sa paggawa ng bagong recipe eh. And of course, we have to think also the cost, no?
Yeah.
Kailangan, win-win tayo dun eh sa paggawa ng recipe.
So yun, typical constraints. Of course, as much as we want to coat our chicken with beer or make it beer battered, that will elevate the cost by a lot, right?
Okay. So we have to have the gochujang.
So in Korea, we have this flavor called snow cheese. We formulated our own recipe for snow cheese, and now I think it's one of our best-selling items. So snow cheese for us, a powder like, it's like snow. It's like snow powder, it's sweet, it's creamy, it's savory, and it differentiates us talaga from other snow cheese sauces, no?
So now we have to add water na, no? 26 grams of water.
So, snow cheese, it was an emerging flavor in Korea. All of my Korean friends were telling me, you have to put snow cheese. This is the number one flavor in Korea right now. So, nag-usap kami ni chef. Sabi ko, tara, ideation meeting tayo. Let's try to develop the snow cheese that everybody wants. And true enough, it's now our best-selling flavor.
And I heard it's a number one now, no?
Yes, it's a best-selling flavor right now. Galing! That's thanks to Chef Ems.
Thanks.
So, our best-selling flavors is snow cheese, yangnyeom, and soy garlic.
Okay, so now we have to add kimchi. 100 grams of kimchi. right? Then we have to add the 3 grams of salt and 2 grams of chili flakes.
Walang MSG yan.
No MSG.
No MSG allowed. We started with 500,000 pesos. Okay? So that 500,000 pesos went to renting a small cloud kitchen. Of course, the security deposits, the advance rentals. Okay? It went to purchasing equipment. An important thing that I want to tell the viewers here is that don't shortchange yourself when purchasing equipment. Huwag kayo bumili ng non-industrial level or low-grade materials. Because I think this became one of the reasons for our early on success is that we invested already in a nice fryer. Okay, we invested in a commercial-grade fryer which helped enhance talaga our chicken. Okay, aside from that is, of course, the personal costs. We had to buy stainless tables, we had to buy grills, we had to buy burners, okay, supplies and inventory. So of course kasama na rin doon sa 500,000 is yung pag R&D mo. I think we spent around 50,000 pesos on testing different types of sauces. So we were testing yangnyeom, soy garlic. We made 10 batches each. We had focus group discussions. Of course, we had to give it out to our friends and family for them to rate, right? But you don't have to start with capital or puhunan that big. To be honest, when I started my first business in Lasal, our capital was 200,000 pesos. And that is just for a 9 square meter stall. So, essentially, the sky's the limit, of course. You can start small and just scale up, right? But, as I said, don't shortchange yourself with cheap equipment because you will benefit from that good investment in the long run. And right now, I want to tell you that even if we've been operating for 3 years already, that same industrial fryer that we bought during the first day is still being used today.
Okay, so it's done.
So this is what the full batch looks like. Yeah. Our creamy kimchi sauce. So mamaya, try natin siya with the chicken to see kung bagay ba siya, right? Kasi it's possible na as is, masarap yung sauce. Pero pag hinalo mo na sa chicken, baka iba na pala yung flavor profile niya, yeah. Diba? Maybe you could start with a fryer of around 25,000 pesos to 35,000 pesos. So that's already commercial grade. Of course, you have to buy supplies worth around, maybe chicken. You can start with around 10,000 pesos worth of chicken. Then, of course, the other ingredients, maybe another 10,000 pesos. So if it's at home, you're not paying any rent. Maybe kayo mga magkakapatid, you guys can be the one working in the kitchen. So there would be no personal costs. Maybe you could start your own small chicken business kahit sa neighborhood nyo lang for around 50,000 pesos. 50 to 60,000 pesos, right? Yeah. And I think many people do that. There are many successful home kitchens that just started with their own kitchen equipment. But of course, for a fried chicken business, what's important talaga is the fryer. So mahirap magluto ng chicken kung i-deep fry mo sa pot.
Yeah.
Okay? So we don't produce any chickens here in the commissary. They're all
store
prepared
level.
In the store level. So per month, I think Bok uses around 20,000 kilos or 20 tons of chicken. And all of our chicken is actually imported. So we import our chicken. It comes in 2 kilogram packs already vacuum sealed, frozen. Right, and in the store level, we just chop and marinate there already.
So the breading,
but the breading comes here. Is prepared here.
So we prepare the breading. We do the R&D for the breading. We prepared here, and then we send to store.
So Bok, we started out with very small sales lang, 10,000 pesos per day, right? 10,000 to 15,000 pesos per day, and this was during the pandemic. So we saw potential when that every single month from August to September to October to November, we had around cumulative increases of 10%, 10 to 20% per month for sales. Okay? So take note that during August, wala pa kaming GrabFood, we were only with Food Panda and had in-house riders. Then the moment we added GrabFood, our sales spiked up. So we made a decision on December that same year, 2020, to open our first physical branch in Taft. So our second branch opened na in Taft on January 2021. Okay? So that moment, I think we were selling around already 50,000 pesos per day for our first branch. So lumaki na talaga ng sobra. Then our second branch in Taft was selling around 20,000 pesos per day. Then that's when we tapped Macro Asia to assist us in the production of our goods. Because, actually, we were only cooking in our very small cloud kitchen. We were making the sauce there and we were having business operations, which is so hard to do. So, effectively, we outgrew our own kitchen. That's why we needed to finally outsource our production to a qualified commissary such as MSFI. Now that you've seen our production, after the production and the cooking of all of the sauces, corn dogs, spaghetti sauce, right? We have to put now the finished products here in the blast freezer. So the reason why we put it in the blast freezer is to eliminate the possibility for bacterial growth. So essentially, freezing the product would stop it. Hi, so we're here today in Bok Korean Fried Chicken Regis Center, located here in Katipunan, Quezon City. So today I'm gonna tour you inside our branch and show you how our kitchen operations go. So, tara! Specifically for this location, our target market is of course the students of Ateneo, Marian College. Right, and the residents living here in the Katipunan area. But generally, Bok wants to target families, barkadas. So right now, we can go inside the kitchen so I can show you the operation inside. Here you can see our menu. Of course, we highlight our boneless Korean fried chicken and the different sides that go with it. And here we have our extras on the other side, our famous corn dogs and skinny fries, which is just a newly launched item. Okay. Then, of course, we sell merchandise also, as you can see here. So, everything will be okay. Okay, so let's start the kitchen tour so that you can see our operation. Come on in. So here we have our kitchen. So, this is our finishing station. So this is where the meals are packed already. This is our saucing station, right? We have here storage in the right side, okay? Then the hot kitchen is here in the back. So the first step dito sa Bok is when we receive our chicken, the chicken is sliced accordingly based on Bok specification, okay? So we target to cut the chicken to around 50 to 60 grams per piece. Alright? So this is usually around 2 inches by 1 inch or 2.5 inch by 1.5. Okay? So after the chicken is cut, we store them in a container for marination. Alright? So, ate, can you show them kung gaano kalaki isang piraso? So this is how big one whole chicken thigh cutlet is. So, we only use chicken thigh fillet because that's the juiciest part of the chicken. Because we don't have any bones, chicken thigh fillet is the next best option. So I think that's what sets Bok apart from other brands, is that we choose the juiciest piece. Not necessarily the meatiest, but the tastiest as well. Our original target market was those people who are aged around 18 years old to 45 years old. Okay, we'd like to call it the aspiring market or the middle class market. But right now, we believe that we can be for everyone. So we actually have customers from A, B, C, and D market because we're good for sharing. So because we serve big pieces, okay, people can share and split the cost easily. Here, we have our Bok proprietary marinating powder. So this is a marinating powder that we developed internally. And of course, it's one of our secret ingredients. So this gives Bok its very flavorful taste in the inside. Okay? So we usually marinate the chicken for around 30 minutes to 1 hour. So after mixing that in, she will put that in the chiller. So this particular branch does around 2 to 2.5 million pesos per month. But that's considering that we just opened recently. So of course, we hope that it will still grow, especially that more Ateneans or more students in the area would find our brand, okay? This is operational from 9 a.m. up to 2 a.m. Okay, so after marinating, she will put it in the chiller to marinate for an hour or so. So once marinated, it will look like this. So this is the finished product already. What she's doing now is putting it on the wet batter, okay? Then putting it on the dry batter. Sige, refill natin. So we have two types of batter. We use the wet batter and the dry batter. This gives it its signature Korean crunch. So because the wet batter coats it and makes it thick, then the dry batter, of course, yan yung parang nagiging crunchy talaga, okay? So after such, we fry it at a temperature of around 175 degrees Celsius. Well, of course, the pros is that it's very familiar, it's easy to market, and everybody loves fried chicken. The cons is that, just like every other restaurant, there's so many moving pieces. Ang dami nangyayari at the same time, so you have to be well-coordinated, you have to have a process, right? And of course, the employees have to be motivated. So what we're gonna do here is, we're gonna do an initial fry of around 6.5 to 7 minutes, okay? And what makes Korean fried chicken unique is that we double fry. So this one, hindi namin to rini-reheat through the fryer. Ah. This is partially cooked chicken. So that when we refry it as a second fry, when we do our second fry for around 2 minutes, it will get very, very crunchy. Okay? So this is just partially fried. This is far fried. So that's what gives its Korean fried chicken crunch. So of course, after frying, we will have to check the order. Here, and for this particular one, we have here soy garlic and yangnyeom. So si Sir Dito, he is now putting soy garlic sauce into the chicken. The first lesson, I think, is when expanding, don't use your working capital. So working capital is basically the lifeblood of your business. Diba? Yan yung dugo na dumadalaw throughout your business. So if you use that for expansion, baka mapila yung negosyo mo. So dito kasi sa Philippines, minsan may stigma na when utilizing credit or loans, diba? So ako, I wish earlier na dapat huwag ka matakot sa mga words na yun. So kung kailangan mo mag-expand, utilize leverage or capital from other people. Okay, don't use your working capital. Otherwise, diba, it's possible na kapag nahirapan, it's hard to operate. It's because we want to expand aggressively. Okay, so of course, our first few expansions, it came through the use of our operating capital. To which, parang later on, na-realize namin, as we're constructing new branches, hindi na namin mabayaran yung payables ng existing branches. So parang sabi ko, hala, paano na yung cash flow natin? Napupunta sa bagong branch, eh hindi pa yun operational. So, nag-research ako, apparently, dapat nga na hindi natin pinaghahalo yung capital expenditures natin sa operational expenditures. Okay? So I think that's a good lesson for those small businesses that want to expand. Diba? It doesn't mean that because you're earning a lot of money na parang pwede mo na ilagay lahat ng pera sa bagong branch. You always have to focus on the operational capacity of your existing branches because that's already working eh. More on managing the cash flow and the inflows and the outflows. Because of course, if may capital expenditures ka, dadagdag yung outflows mo. Right? Pero may priority ka pa na outflows for the existing business already eh. Right? So, that's one of the bigger lessons. And as partners, of course, we had to raise again money from our own pockets for the new branch. So, we realized na parang like, okay, dapat separate talaga yung capital expenditures natin. Let's raise a new set of fresh funds, okay? Huwag natin galawan yung existing operating capital, diba? Para hindi mapila yung mga existing branches natin. So, second is that HR is king, okay? HR is king in maybe all businesses because your business won't survive without proper hiring of personnel, employees, and staff. Diba? The chicken won't cook itself. The chicken won't be sauced by itself, right? We need to make sure that we have very qualified and competent employees who are motivated, who are willing to be trained, okay? Otherwise, kayo mahihirapan. It's because as a business owner, especially if you're expanding, you can't be in all locations at once. That's why you have to have trusted personnel, trusted employees that you can rely on. So that's why HR should be your number one priority. Kung wala yung proper hiring mo ng employees, right? If you're not able to properly compensate them or provide benefits, it's possible that your business will have a lot of difficulty operating or growing. So here we have our kimchi fried rice. Oh, so dinesign talaga namin yung mga containers namin to be very very presentable para pwede kang mag-enjoy kahit sa bahay ka. So mayroon pa dito nakasabi our bocada. Some garnish, seaweed. So the third lesson is many people ask me, bakit ka nagnegosyo with your friends? I'm sure maraming interesado dyan. The key point in doing business with your friends is you guys should have the same work ethic, okay? Otherwise, it won't work. Because if you see somebody na slacking off, iba yung way nila para magtrabaho, iba yung style nila, dun kayo magkakatalunan, okay? And of course, you guys have to identify who the leader is. Otherwise, magkakapikunan kayo, diba? So there has to be mutual respect within one another for you to have a good, successful, and harmonious business. So in our example, all of us are friends. We're close friends. One of my partners, Miguel, he's one of my best friends. Deo, kababata ko siya. He's my neighbor growing up. Okay? Nag-aaway-aaway ba kami right now in business? Hindi kami nag-aaway-aaway. But we have arguments that are very constructive. So the key to doing business talaga with friends is that you have to respect each other. You have to know their work ethic, di ba? Then that should be the key element when identifying who your business partners are. So this doesn't just go with friends. This goes also with strangers, di ba? You have to identify, paano ba yung work ethic nitong tao? Di ba? Does it match mine? Di ba? Otherwise, when you go home, parang iisipin mo, ha, bakit niya ginawa yun? Kasi hindi mo maintindihan. Diba? So I think that's one of the biggest lessons, especially when doing business with friends. So respect each other, okay? Know each other's work ethic, then use your own personal strengths and weaknesses. So for example, when Deo joined our company, he started muna working with marketing. Then we later identified that he had strengths in operations, so now he heads our operations, right? So Ralph naman, he started at operations. Now, he's more in our purchasing and procurement, diba? So, we find each other's strengths, we balance each other out, okay? Then, we respect each other so much, diba? Para hindi mag-away-away talaga. So here we have the skinny fries. So we cook this for around 2 minutes to maintain the crispiness on the outside, but also the flavor of the potato in the inside. Okay? Yan. Ito, personally, this is one of my favorite side dishes eh. Sarap kasi. We don't advertise this directly, but Bok is open to franchising the business to key competent individuals. So if you're interested, of course, you may send your letter of intent to bokfranchising@aviph.com. So our team will evaluate, we can discuss with you if you have a potential location, right? Then of course, this is a good opportunity, especially if you want to get into business. So, individuals that we look for, of course, are those who already have work experience, okay? Those who have a professional background, and maybe somebody looking for a second business, diba? Because our operation here, as you can see, is very complex. There's many things going on, right? So, of course, we want you to already come with a background. We want people who have professional experience to be able to handle the operations, to be able to handle the customers, right? Because this goes beyond what you see in the kitchen, right? We have our business operations, such as doing purchasing. We have your accounting, we have your finance, okay? So it's better to build your experience first, right? Then you can start your Bok business franchise. So right now we have 16 branches, but we have 3 branches right now under construction in De La Rosa, Makati, in California Garden Square in Mandaluyong, and in President's Avenue in BF Homes. So, of course, there's more to come. Hopefully, next month, we're able to secure more locations, right? Then, through the power of franchising, of course, we welcome those interested individuals to pitch their proposed locations. So, hopefully, we grow the Bokada together and grow our store network all over the Philippines. This branch is also a franchise. So we know the franchisee. He's actually one of our rice suppliers. So do we consider our business a successful story? So definitely coming from our small kitchen roots in Alabang Zapote, and we've grown to over 16 to hopefully 19 by the end of March. It's definitely a success story, but definitely we're not satisfied where we are right now. We want to continue growing. We want to continue being more sustainable and to provide more and more jobs and opportunities for everyone. So this doesn't only go for the employees or the staff, right? It also goes to providing opportunities to interested business-minded individuals who want to own their own branch like this, right? So, of course, we're relatively successful, but if we have the mindset that we're already there, then that might make us more complacent to working harder. So, ano naman, us all friends, us all partners, we're all very hardworking, so you know, success never ends. So we always want to go further and further. So hopefully in the next 5 years, we've opened 100 branches all over the Philippines, right? Hopefully we reach our target of becoming a billion peso company by the end of 2025. So my message for everyone is that when doing business, especially food-related business, don't be intimidated by your background. All of us partners, I'm an accountant, our other partner's an accountant, our other partner's a banker, right? Another one is an entrepreneur, okay? So don't be intimidated, don't be pressured that you have to have some sort of culinary background. So definitely study up, learn the tools of the trade, 5K and market like crazy. So when we started this business, I told our partners that this is a marketing game, okay? We have to have strong marketing, know how to sell their business, know how to work hard, and everything else will follow, okay? So there isn't any magical ingredient in doing business. It's all really a culmination of hard work, being ethical, being sustainable, and respecting everyone from your managers to your employees. We have right now over 16 locations. Hopefully by the end of March, that's already 19. So we have locations all over Metro Manila. We have in Subic, Olongapo. We have two locations in Tarlac. We have in Binian, Laguna. We have in Imus, Cavite. We have in Bacoor, right? So, and many, many more to come. So we're also available in Grab, Grab Food and Food Panda. So hopefully we'll be in every city in Metro Manila by the end of the year. So just try to find the nearest box, nearest to you. You can order through Grab, you can order through Food Panda, and we'll try to make sure that you get the best service and experience possible.